Hi, welcome to the third session on digital principles and system design. In this video, we'll discuss about the number conversions from any other number system to decimal number system. So, in the last lecture, we have seen how to convert given a decimal number, how to convert to any one of the other number system like binary, octal or hexadecimal. And in this lecture, given any number in any one of these number system like binary, octal or hexadecimal, we will convert that number to an equivalent decimal number. And how to convert the number given in binary to octal and from binary to hexadecimal, hexadecimal to binary, octal to binary, octal to hexadecimal and hexadecimal to octal. So consider a number given in a number system with radix r which we wanted to convert to a decimal number. So multiply each number by its positional weight to get the partial product and add all the partial products in step 1 to get the equivalent number in decimal. Say for example, we have a number in binary 1001 binary point 11. This we wanted to convert to a decimal number. So start from the binary point. So to the left of binary point is 1 whose positional weight is 2 power 0. So 1 into 2 power 0. This is one partial product. This has to be added with 0 into 2 power 1, which is the positional weight, plus 0 into 2 power 2 plus 1 into 2 power 3 plus after binary point we have 1 into its positional weight is 2 power 1 plus this 1 into 2 power minus 2. When we add up all these things we get 9.75, which is a decimal number equivalent to 1001.11 in binary. Next is an example, a number given in octal which we wanted to convert to decimal. The procedure is the same. Multiply each digit with its positional weight and add them all together. So 2 into 8 power minus 2, which is equal to 0.03125, and 1 into 8 power minus 1, which is 0.125, and 5 into 8 power 0, which is 5, and 0 into anything is 0, but its positional weight is 8 power 1, and 7 into 8 power 2, which is 448. When we add them all together, we get 453.15625 in decimal, which is equivalent to 705.12 in octal. We'll consider one more example wherein we will convert a number given in hexadecimal number system to decimal number system. Again, we wanted to convert 70B.12 in the hexadecimal number system to decimal number system. So start from this hexadecimal point. So this is 16 power minus 1. This is 16 power minus 2. So 2 into 16 power minus 2 plus 1 into 16 power minus 1 plus what is B in hexadecimal? This is actually equivalent to 11. So 11 into 16 power 0, 0 into 16 power 1 plus 7 into 16 power 2, and when you add them all together you get 1803.0703125 in decimal, which is equivalent to 70B.12 in hexadecimal. Now we will consider how to convert a number given in binary number system to octal number system. So we should group 3 bits together from binary point towards left and right. That is, the integer part has to be grouped into 3 bits together starting from the binary point and going towards the left, and the fractional part we have to group them together into a group of 3 bits starting from the binary point and moving towards the right. And when we proceed like this, when we reach the leftmost bit, if there is not sufficient bits to group them into a group of 3 bits, we can add padding zeros, preceding zeros, which will not change the value. Similarly, when you go towards the right in the fractional part, if some bits are left without any group of 3 bits, then we can add some succeeding zeros, which will also not change the value of the binary number. And then for each of the 3-bit group, we can have the corresponding octal number written. And the mapping between the 3-bit binary pattern and the octal digit is given in this table. 000 will represent 0, 001 is 1, and so on till 111 is 7. So I will see an example. We have this number, okay, binary number, and we will start from this binary point and travel towards the left in the integer part, and in the fractional part we will move towards the right. So we have the 001, that is one group, and then 101 is another group, and then we have 111, that is another group, and this leftmost one is left alone. So to make it a group of 3 bits, we add 2 preceding zeros. When you add preceding zeros, this value will not get altered. Okay, remember, when you have a number in decimal number system, say 525, if I add a 0 before it, 0525, the value will not change. Okay, the same thing happens here as well. So I can add preceding zeros here, and here after the binary point you have 101, that is one group, and this one is alone. So add preceding zeros. So after decimal point, if I add zeros, or binary point, if I add zeros, the value will not get altered. Okay, the same, similar to that of the decimal number system. Say suppose if I have 0.5, if I add a 0 after that, 0.05 is also equal to 0.5, right? So the value will not get altered. Now we can just have a mapping. Okay, I have 001. Okay, so what is 001? In octal it is 1, so I can write 1. 111, it is equivalent to octal 7, I can write 7, and so on, and I can get the octal representation of the binary number. Now we will consider how to convert the octal number, number given in the octal number system, to binary. So every octal digit I can write as an equivalent group of 3 bits in binary. We know this mapping already, so we can just use it. Okay, say for example I have 532.047 in octal, which has to be converted to a binary number. So I can write 5, I can write its corresponding pattern, which is 101. So I can write it as 101, 3 is 011, and so on. So I can write the corresponding bit patterns from the table and get the binary number. Now we'll consider how to convert the binary number to hexadecimal number. So it is very similar to the conversion from binary to octal. Instead of a group of 3 bits, now we wanted to form a group of 4 bits together, and the same procedure, we can add preceding zeros in the integer part if necessary, and we can add succeeding zeros in the fractional part if necessary. And the mapping between 4 bit binary patterns and the hexadecimal digits are given in this table, and you should be familiar with this bit patterns, and you should know what corresponds to what. So as an example, we will consider the same number in binary. Now starting from the binary point, okay, group 4 bits together. Okay, so we have 1011, and then 1110 is another group. Add 2 preceding zeros to make it 4 bits. So this is, and same as true with the fractional part, I have 1011, so we have 4 bits, and we just stop it there. And now I can find the corresponding bit pattern here. So this is 3 actually, and 0001 is actually E, and 1011 is b. So I have 3EB dot b in hexadecimal. Now how to convert number given in hexadecimal number system to binary? Okay, the reverse procedure. So for each digit in hexadecimal number system, I have to use this table to map it to 4-bit pattern in the binary. So 4 I have to represent in binary as 0100, and I can get that, and C will be represented as 1100 and so on. If I write it like this, I will get the corresponding number in binary. And now let's see how to convert the number given in octal number system to hexadecimal number system. So a number given in octal number system, we can convert easily to binary number system, because each digit in octal is going to correspond to 3 bits in binary. And now we can group this binary number as a group of 4 bits together and convert them to hexadecimal number. For example, 472.5. And this O actually represents that this number is in octal number system. It's not necessarily that I have to write the bases 8. I can give O to represent that this is a octal number system. So I can write 4 as 1007 as 111 and so on. And then I have to regroup this one to make it a group of 4 bits together. So I'll have this 1010 and 0011, and then I don't have anything here for one, so I add 3 preceding zeros. Similarly, I'll add one more succeeding zeros here. Now I can use the 4-bit pattern and the hexadecimal mapping and convert this to hexadecimal number. And here I use H instead of the base 16. I can write H to represent that this is a hexadecimal number. And the reverse process of converting a hexadecimal number to octal number system is also similar. I will use the binary number system in between. I will convert the hexadecimal number to binary and then from binary to octal. Okay, so given the hexadecimal number, I will write the corresponding binary number using the 4-bit pattern. I will regroup them to make it as a group of three bits together, and then write their corresponding octal number. And in the next video, we will look into how to do the arithmetic with all number system that we have seen, that is the binary number system, the hexadecimal, octal and decimal number system. And thank you for watching the video.